Take your card, oh. to Mr. Leon Jerry Johnson. Passed away this past Friday, March 11th, 2022, at Cape Fear Medical Center in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Mr. Johnson was born on September 12th, 1937, in Harnett County, to the late William Jasper and Reeby McClown Johnson. He was preceded in death by his wife, Glenda Diane Johnson, and also a daughter, baby girl Johnson. Mr. Johnson was the owner and operator of Johnson's Better Care of Dunn, North Carolina, and also he served our country in the U.S. Air Force. The family says he loved golf, boating, Myrtle Beach, and telling stories about his father and grandfather. Surviving includes his children, which is her daughter, Jerry Johnson, son, Will Jason Johnson, and wife, Jaden, grandchildren, Holly Angela, Riley Marie, Jody Diane, Jessica Clever, and 4-year-old William Jasper Johnston II. One sister, Janie Mike Johnson, and a special dog, Jake Johnson, and several nieces and nephews. I'd like to share a scripture with you before I pray. In Matthew chapter 5, and I'd like to read just 5 verses. It says, one day he saw the crowds gathering, and Jesus went up on the mountains and sat down. It says his disciples gathered around him, and he began to teach them. It says, blessed are those who are poor and realize their need for him. For the kingdom of heaven is theirs. God blesses those who mourn, for they will be comforted. God blesses those who are humble, for they shall inherit the whole earth. God blesses those who hunger and thirst for justice, for they shall be satisfied. God blesses those who are merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. God blesses those whose hearts are pure, for they will see God. God blesses those who work for peace, for they will be called the children of God. And God blesses those who are persecuted for doing right, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Let us pray. Our Father, we humbly come before you today. Thank you for your word, for the truth of this word, Lord. Today, Lord, as we here to recognize and give honor to Mr. Jerry Johnson, I think God had this in mind for such a man as this, as he was talking to his disciples, because he knew they were going to be serving this type of people. And I just thank you, God, for the life of our brother today, Lord. And thank you for their family. I know it's a time of sorrow and a time of grief. But we thank you for your presence, God. You have promised us, Lord, that you will always be with us and that you're the ever-present help. And we give you thanks for that today, God. So I pray, Lord, this service today, that you would give us peace in your presence. And may the family be blessed and touched by your love. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
No, I-
Jesus was speaking to his disciples after his resurrection. He had met with them. They went to the mountain where he told them to be. He says, "Let not your heart be troubled. For you are trusting God, not trusting me. There are many homes up here where my Father lives, and I'm going to prepare them where we're coming. When everything is ready, then I will come and get you, so that you will always be with me where I am." And Jesus says, "If this were not so, I would tell you plainly." Amen. You know, Jerry and Diane go back many years of memory for my family. I can remember the birth of Johnson's Medicare in 301. And also can remember when Jerry and Jason not being out of diapers too long. And Jerry, since a child, was a very close friend to our daughter, Angela. Jason, surely I remember you, son, but did not see you as often as I did Jerry. Also remember Diane's brother. I want to mention this. Dr. Brooks Wilkins, and Darlene. Thanks to Diane, our daughter Jane, right out of nursing school, Dr. Wilkins gave Jane her first job. I hope Dr. Wilkins is here today. Because I always want to say thank you. In Matthew's gospel, let me turn and read this. Verses, starting with verse 16 through 20. This talks about the Great Commission. Again, Jesus meeting with his disciples. The 11 disciples left for Galilee, going to the mountains where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshiped him. But some of them doubted that it was Jesus. Jesus came and told his disciples, I have been given all authority in the heavens and earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He said, teach these new disciples to obey the commands I have given them, and be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end. Now this was, again, I'll say, this was after the resurrection of Jesus, and he was commissioning them to go into all the world and preach the gospel. Well, you know, in my day, of course many of you, Reverend Billy Graham was the most famous preacher. He was a man of God in America. He was the most famous preacher in America and around the world. He was called of God, like the disciples were. You know. And with a vision and a plan, he had a purpose to win souls. Now let me say this. I don't sound like that I'm comparing Jerry Johnson or Roy Johnson to Reverend Graham. And let me say also that God don't compare. Notice Peter reminds us, he says, then Peter opened his mouth and said the truth. I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. I'm so glad of that. You know, God loves you much as he does me. And that's God. But for the last 45 years, Jerry and his wife Diane, before her homegoing, gave their all 24/7, like Billy Graham, serving God's people. You know, like the little Sunday school song we used to sing, red, yellow, black, or white, they're all precious in God's sight. As we read, Jesus commissioned his disciples, go ye into all the world and preach the good news. You know, centuries later, you know, Billy Graham got the call. And as we know, he carried out this commission till he was promoted to heaven. Amen?
Amen.
In Acts chapter 4, allow me to read. It says, but as believers, rapidly multiplied. frame, there were rumblings of discontent. The Greek-speaking believers complained about the Hebrew-speaking believers, saying that their widows were being discriminated against in the daily distribution of food. So the 12 called a meeting of all the believers, and they said, "We apostles should spend our time teaching the word of God, not running a food program." And so, brothers, select 7 men who are well respected and are full of the spirit and wisdom, and we will give them this responsibility. Then we apostles can spend our time in prayer for teaching of the word. The King James says they were given this responsibility of running a business. You know, time will not allow me to explain, but this is the early beginning of a business ministry. Taking care of people in need of a shelter, in need of health needs. Like Billy Graham, now Bill and Jerry Johnson has been promoted to heaven. And like the Great Commission, this ministry will continue also until the church is raptured. You know, Mr. Jerry Johnson and Reverend Billy Graham, they are two different men. But they're servants of God, had a major impact upon people. You know, I don't have this in my notes to say. I was in the business world, and late in life, God called me into the ministry. He put me in the hospital. 20 years I've served the hospital, and now I'm serving hospice. I know what Jerry did. I know what kind of place he ran. I know how he helped so many people, like all of our facilities. You know, we're just so blessed to have facilities to help those that don't have. It's not as blessed as some to have children to look after. I didn't cost you nothing. As I mentioned, you know, Jerry and I were both in businessmen, a lot of responsibility. We did not see each other that often, but always he and Diane were our friends, Jason. We were always friends. They both, I do remember, was very well known and respected in our city and, of course, the Mary Stewart community. Janie, his sister, said that she lived in the community like her mom and dad most all of her life. And she said that Jerry was the most wonderful brother in the world. She said it was always just them two. In the obituary, I read that Jerry loved telling stories of his father and his grandfather. I bet they were interested. I wish I could have had a cup of coffee with them and heard some of their stories. No doubt, you kids heard them, didn't you? Probably over and over, right? One thing I learned from our daughter, Angela, growing up with her best friend, Jerry. There was a big Jerry and a little Jerry. They had two other friends. It was, Angie said it was four of them, which was little Jerry, Angela, Pat, and Allison. Allison is here today. They all came last night. And Angela said they all love big Jerry and Diane. She said Big Jerry was a good friend to Dad. A good friend to the friends. Dad. She said it was always a fun environment. A good place to hang out. A good house to hang out at. Says he liked to be at their parties. Take them skating to the beach. Watch them play football. It was, and she said, as always, he and Diane was with him. I think Jesus said it best. Now, I've said a lot of things, but I think Jesus said it best, describing a good dad. And I think this is what one of the thoughts he was thinking about when Jesus was teaching his disciples. It says, blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. That's what God looks at. He looks at our heart, doesn't he? We can, that's the reason we don't judge. God sees the hearts. Let me say to the family, Jerry, Jason, and Julia, Alejandra, Riley Marie, Jody Diane, Jessica Clinton, and little Jasper the two. Let me say this. You are so blessed with the heritage your parents and grandparents held up to you. You have so many precious memories to cherish. A great legacy to stay true to. The family, you know, have always been what America stands for. The land of the free. Home of the brave. And today, at the graveside, military honors will be given to your dad and granddad for serving our country. And you have a right to be proud. Hallelujah. I visited the family this past Sunday afternoon, and Jason shared with me. And this was Jason's words. My dad was a devout Christian. And again, Jason, I say hallelujah. I will close with this amazing promise. For this is how God loved the world, it says, John 3:16. He gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. To God be you all.
When Christ shall come.
Spent so much time with Angela, and I was telling Jillian this morning, it's been 40 years since you graduated. But we have a lot of good memories. So I was just thinking, I just want to give you a blessing from God. It says, "May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you peace." Hallelujah. I close with the 23rd Psalm. I think if your dad knew any of it, I would give you this Psalm. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup overrunneth. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And then, this is the promise, I will dwell in the house of the Lord